In this problem, we're given an n times m grid consisting of zeros and ones. In a flip, we can change the value of a 0 to a 1 or a 1 to a 0. We're meant to find the minimum number of flips such that all even length square submatrices have an odd number of ones in them, or print minus 1 if this can't be done. Let's take a look at a 4 times 5 grid. It consists of two 4 times 4 square submatrices. Let's look at one of these submatrices. It consists of four 2 times 2 square submatrices. Each of these 2 times 2 submatrices need to have an odd number of ones. But since a 4 times 4 submatrix consists of four 2 times 2 submatrices, and 4 times an odd number is equal to an even number, the answer is minus 1 whenever n is greater than or equal to 4. Now if n is equal to 1, it's easy to see that the answer is 0 as we never have any even length square submatrices. Now we're left with just n is equal to 2 and n is equal to 3. We can use a bitmask dp to solve this problem now. Let dp of I of mask denote the minimum number of changes to make the matrix till the ith column good, if the last column is mask. Let's take a look at this with an example. If mask is 6 and n is equal to 3, let's try and figure out what we can transition over from. Let's place a 1 at the top of the I minus first column. Notice that this sets what the second bit will be. The top 2 times 2 square submatrix already has 3 ones, so the missing element has to be a 0. If it's a 1, we end up with a 2 times 2 square submatrix with an even number of ones. Now we have another 2 times 2 submatrix with one element missing. This time, 3 of the elements have a total of 1 1. Hence the missing element has to be a 0. As if it were a 1, we'd have an even number of 1s in the bottom 2 times 2 submatrix. Hence we know that we can transition over from 4 if mask is equal to 6. But what if the top bit is 0? Again, we end up with a 3 element filled submatrix, from where we can figure out what the rest of the previous mask will be. In this case, we get 3. Hence the previous mask in column I minus 1 can either be a 3 or a 4, if the mask in the ith column is 6. As the top bit for the previous mask can only be a 0 or a 1, we can transition over from at most 2 states for a particular mask. Hence, if we pre-calculate what these values are, we arrive at the following if n is equal to 3. If n is equal to 2, these are the pre-calculated values we get. However, this doesn't account for the fact that there's a cost associated with flipping some of the values in the grid to arrive at the current mask. This is simply the number of bits in the mask which aren't the same as the values in the ith column. This ends up being the number of set bits in the XOR of the mask and the column in the grid. The answer is then just the minimum of dp of m of mask, where mask represents all possible masks. Let's look at the code now for n is equal to 3. Grid mask denotes the bit mask value of the ith column. Mask denotes the value that we want the ith column to be. So we initially set dp3imask to a value larger than the largest possible answer. Then we start iterating over what the mask in the i-1st column could be. We keep these pre-computed in a table called ok3, where ok3ij is true if the mask I can be placed in the column before mask j, or false otherwise. If ok3previousmask is false, we continue. Otherwise, we can transition over from dp3i-1previousmask and add the number of set bits in gridmask XOR mask. Built-in pop count is a C++ function which can calculate the number of set bits in a number. Now the answer is simply the minimum of dp3mi, where I denotes all possible masks. So that's how you solve problem D. I hope that was helpful. I have video editorials for A, B, C, and E too. So if you're interested, please check them out. If you found this helpful, please subscribe to my channel. I'm not quite sure what kinds of videos I'm going to make yet, but I do think that 3Blue 1 Brown styled competitive programming videos would be helpful. Please like, share, and comment, and feel free to share any suggestions that you might have.